Okay, we have an iPhone 11 Pro Max here. So go to setting, general, about 11 Pro Max. Okay, this is 64 gig. And the problem is when you put a SIM card, no service. Okay, the problem is no service. So let's put the SIM card there. And make sure the IMEI baseband. Make sure the IMEI is working. Baseband is working. Okay. So baseband is working fine. So we're gonna put the SIM card. See. Okay, she's searching. Let's take a look. Everything is connected. Okay, antenna. And it's still searching. So 4G is enabled. Seems like hard to get the signal. Okay. So it's showing no service. Okay, now we are going to go to here, mobile selection. Okay, network selection. Turn off automatic and see whether he can find the signal, whether he can detect the carrier. Okay. Okay, it seems every signal is detected because my area have all these. Alright, it's still no signal. So you just have to make sure it is not a telco log, okay? Because Malaysia have a telco log. So it is not a telco log. So the second symptoms we're gonna look is if I change it to 3G, whether I can get the signal. Still searching. Okay, no service. Then we are confirmed that it have a network IC problem. Okay, without the SIM card, we can even call the emergency. Okay, if it can be called, then there's a possibility with the SIM card itself, or either the phone is locked by the carrier. If it show call fail, that means the network IC have a problem. Okay, something wrong with the network circuit. In this series, there's a lot of common issue. Okay, one of the lines is very easy to get shot, especially 3W. Okay, so emergency call is not able to go out. Okay, call fail. Alright, so let's turn off. Unplug the battery before we unplug everything. Okay, we already removed the screw. So let's begin to repair the board. So iPhone 11 Pro series, they are the sandwich board. Okay, this is 11 Pro Max. Okay, the device is never repaired before. In this generation of the 11, okay, in 11 series, this generation, all the network IC is separate, okay. So some of the network IC is located on the top board, and some of them are on the lower board. So this will make us harder to troubleshoot. Okay, in iPhone 10 series, iPhone 10s, they are easy because even you don't know how to repair the network IC, you can just swap over the lower board. Okay, just move the baseband CPU, baseband EEPROM, the Wi-Fi into the new board. Okay, problem solved. NFC also. But in this generation, some of the network IC is on the top board. So if you just swap the lower board, you might still have a problem. So it will make you more. It will make your job more complicated. The SOP for looking the symptom is much more important. Okay, and then you begin in somewhere else. Okay, we approach from different angle to troubleshoot the board. Okay, this generation is a little different. Okay, so when it's ready, then you just take off like this. Okay, in this generation of the network IC, they are easily to get problem in this area. Okay, as you can see, some of the network IC on the lower board and some of them on the top here. So that's a common issue located in this area. All we need to do is measure the resistance of here. Okay. Okay, the first thing I measure will be the 3 watt of here. Okay. So look at the schematic. Watt. Located in this area. So if nothing short in this area, then you measure all the resistance surrounding. Okay, so immediately I found a short. So this line short again. This is a very common issue for this problem. Okay, in this dot it should be 480 resistance, huh? So now I get 0.00. Okay, the ground. So this is really, really common issue, huh? It's time to use the thermometer. Okay, now we are looking at the board. Okay, so now we are looking at the board. And I'm gonna bump the power in to look and so as you can see, there's a heat on the top left corner. Okay, it is here. So more likely is the one of the cap is getting problem. Okay, now look at again. Do not inject the power mod in. So the shot is this one. Now we look at schematic. Yes, confirm. So once I remove this, the shot will be gone. So I do blinking. You can see? Okay, confirm. So this is the problem, and I'm gonna just remove it. Okay. So not going to replace it. Okay, now measure the resistance again. Okay, so resistance is back 478 K00. Okay, done. So some people that don't reboot at all to put it back, but in this generation, if you do like that, there might be a problem if the user is dropping just a little bit. Okay, so it's best I reboot. Okay, so let's reboot. Okay, now what we are doing is changing the low milk. Okay. Seems like they turn off the aircon. Thank you. Okay. Okay, so prepare for installation. So we need to measure the voltage resistance before we turn on. Okay, so if they're okay, then use power supply to check. Okay, so using power supply check current. Okay, so seems okay. So let's try to turn on. Okay, last you connect the battery. Okay, and then check the other function before you check it. Check the SIM card. Okay. So look at the setting things here. Wi-Fi, Bluetooth address, they all remain. Baseband working. Okay. So Wi-Fi, Bluetooth are still running. Press the *#06#. Okay. Alright, and then put the SIM card. There. Okay. So the signal is back. So let's turn off the Wi-Fi. Okay, we can see there's 3G. Because my SIM card, this carrier, that's really weak in 4G in my area. Okay, so the 4G should be working fine. Okay, so let's try call in. Okay. So this is one of the very common issue for the 11 series. Okay, you run Pro, you run Pro Max. Okay, and this is how to repair the iPhone 11 Pro or Pro Max Lego issue. Okay, this is one of the most common problem, but it's best you have all the equipment. You know, you will need the thermal camera in order to do this fast. Okay, I don't want to see you randomly to remove the things that you haven't verified, you know. So there's still some of the technician there that just change the things on the way, you know. So don't do that. Okay, see you guys. Bye.